Exactly.
So artificial insemination and embryo transfer are becoming increasingly common techniques. Would you mind walking us through the processes and the benefits that these have for breeders?
Yeah, as for artificial insemination, this is a very good thing for the owners of the mares, but also for the owners of the stallions. So you can use semen of the stallion all over the country or all over the world, and you don't have to drive with the mare. So shipping of the semen is beneficial and very allowed breeder to use wide range of stallions. And this is safe, very safe. It's safe for the mare and it's safe for the stallion. Not only about injury that the mare can kick the stallion and or opposite, but also because of the contamination which stallion can bring to mare before he got some not really clean mare. So these are the two major things. And I think that this is the good way for the breeders to improve also their breeding program. And as for the embryo transfer, this is really good thing if you have a sport mare.
Absolutely. And, I mean, it's just changing
so
much.
Yeah.
Great.
You saw I was just smiling when I started talking about it.
Yeah.
It's so you can use your sport mare for the breeding in the same time. And this is just awesome because normally you need to take out the mare from the sport for a year and a half. And going back with a good condition to start going some sport again, it's another time. So with embryo transfer, you can have just one. I think one will be enough, or two per season. You don't have to need 10 in 1 year, but just one. When you have a good mare, sport mare, and she's doing really good, it's also very nice to check her as a mother.
Yes, she produces.
Not waiting till the end of her career when she's 16 or 17. And we can, with normal insemination, you can have two or three foals. Mm. But if you check her before and she's getting really good results as an older mare, you already have a young horse
coming
ride.
Up.
Yeah, so this is not the only thing. You can also try embryo transfer with the mares. You have some troubles with carrying the pregnancy till term. This is also a good solution for this kind of things. And of course, you can have many foals in one season.
Yes, I think it opens up that as you said, that pool of really good dam lines. It makes it more accessible to us because people aren't worried about keeping them off of the competition circuits for a year.
Exactly.
So I think our stallion owners are probably very au fait with artificial insemination, collecting their horses. For a mare owner, what is the process? Anna, just briefly, I mean, I know it's quite complicated and you have done a PhD on it. What is the process that they could expect if they wanted to A, inseminate their mare, or B, harvest an embryo from her?
So these are two things which are one after another. So for embryo transfer, you also need to inseminate the mare. So with insemination, the only thing which change is you need to examine the mare in the heat to get the right moment for insemination. So this is the one change. And the second, that the vet is putting the semen into the uterus, not the stallion. So it's just like when you can check your mare with that, or you can see that she's in the heat, you just need to check how big is the follicle and if the uterus is have this heat edema. And then in the right time, you can order the semen, I'm talking about fresh semen, and inseminate usually next day or even the same day if the stallion is not far away. So it's not a problem, I think.
And obviously then an embryo transfer becomes a much more complicated process, and we're going to assume that people have already identified one or hopefully two donor mares. And then the process of sinking them starts?
Yes, yeah, so when we inseminate the mare for the embryo transfer, we are collecting the embryo at day 7 or 8 after ovulation. So the tricky thing in embryo transfer is that we need to synchronize the recipient mares in which we are going to put the embryos in. And the synchronization is more or less that the recipient mares has to have heat in the same time as donor mare. And we have to think about before, not at the moment of embryo transfer, but before when we are inseminating our donor mare. And it's best to have 2 or 3 recipient mares for one donor in case if they won't ovulate or have some troubles in their uterus and so on.